How YouTube ranks videos actually starts at the moment that you upload a video. You know when it says processing? First of all, it downscales the resolution of your video, but it also analyzes your videos. First on the objects and tags that are in the video. Second, it looks at your video chapter names. Number three, it looks at the speech of your video. And number four, it looks at the text in your title and thumbnail. And based on this, it generates internal metadata. Let's call it internal search labels for now. Based on these search labels, it determines the topic of the video and therefore, in large part, the initial audience that might be interested in your video. So what happens in terms of ranking when you release a video? According to this paper by Google about how YouTube ranking works, which I heavily used to research this video, AI is biased towards the past to predict the future. Because over time, an AI model, which is your video, is trained with more and more data, so it becomes more and more reliable. Because it has more and more data about the right audience for that video. And this is literally what you can see happening here in your views graph in YouTube Analytics. And this is YouTube literally training the AI model of my video here. How does YouTube train models for the ranking? You know those search labels that I talked about earlier? YouTube estimates which of those search labels are the most important for your video and starts to test those labels on actual human beings when you release a video. The bigger your channel is, the more labels it tests on a larger audience. For each of these search labels, it looks at how the viewer satisfaction is for that search label when it comes to YouTube search. It looks at average view duration, average percentage viewed, click-through rate, engagement, and a couple of other things that YouTube is pretty secretive about. And this is what most creators misunderstand about average view duration and especially click-through rate, because it's so extremely relative to the competition on that specific video with that specific topic, on that specific video length, on that specific audience, with that specific age, and 10 other specific things. Average percentage viewed is a little bit more reliable when you take video length into account because, for example, unlike CTR, every traffic source is counted. YouTube recently gave us some APV numbers to shoot for, which you can see here on the screen. But remember, this is an average over all of YouTube in all niches and all topics. You might have spotted a flaw in how YouTube ranks videos in my previous explanation. Because if the YouTube algorithm thinks that older videos are better because it has more data on them, it would only serve old videos. And when it would serve only old videos, it doesn't get data to train models of new videos. It's kind of the chicken or the egg problem. To break this vicious cycle, YouTube thought of something brilliant. On release, they give videos an enormous kick in the ass by serving it to a large audience for the first few days. And I say large in quotes because it depends heavily on the size of your channel, how large this audience is, which makes content freshness a ranking factor. And this is the spike that you always see in your YouTube analytics when you release a video. And by doing this, YouTube can gather data on average view duration, click-through rate, etc. to establish a baseline for future promotion. On release, YouTube starts testing for the usual suspects for viewer satisfaction. So it starts first with your subscribers. When they react very well, then it starts with your regular viewers. Then if they react very well in click-through rate, average percentage viewed, etc., then it goes to the next group. And every single time that group gets larger and larger and larger and larger. And it keeps promoting until it finds a group that is not interested. And these are the spikes and the dips you see in a views graph on a viral hit. Because every time when viewers are satisfied, you can see that it promotes to a next bigger group of people. And every time when it hits a group that isn't as interested, you can see a dip in that views graph. And this is why momentum is so extremely important for a small channel. Because if you can hit those number 1, 2, and 3 positions on your YouTube dashboard consistently, you will get a little bit more tests on your next video and therefore probably a little bit more promotion and therefore probably a little bit more views on your next video. On release, your audience and similar viewers get a notification on their home screen or in YouTube suggested. And in YouTube search, you preliminary rank between the big channels. This is a screenshot of one of my videos ranking on position number 3 on a pretty competitive search term right after release. So you actually rank in between the big guys. Isn't that bizarre? This is your chance to prove to the algorithm that your video is better than all the others. And if you blow it, and I think that 99.9% of YouTube creators blow it, otherwise you've had a viral hit, then you start to go down the rankings after a few hours, like I did in my case with this video. And the bigger your channel is, the higher it initially ranks, the more tests it does with more search labels, and thus the chance that it finds the right audience immediately is much bigger. But actually, you get a second chance. When I released it 4 months ago, it was on position number 3. After that, the video took a nosedive in the rankings and slowly now starts to crawl up again. And I suspect that somewhere in the next few days, I'm going to outrank this dude simply because I have a reason to click in my thumbnail. He doesn't. And the audience retention graph of this video is ridiculously good and flat as a pancake. In other words, I keep viewers in the video. Some creators try to explain why and how YouTube ranks videos by looking at granular details of a video, like the relationship between impressions and click-through rate, for example. But that will never make sense because, first of all, you don't have all the data that the YouTube algorithm has. Remember, YouTube is pretty secretive about some of those ranking factors. And second of all, if you have only 200 views on a video, your video model is trained with too little data about audience for the YouTube algorithm to promote it. How YouTube ranking works for the viewer. Until now, I've talked from the perspective of the creator because it's easier to understand what's going on, but actually, it's the other way around. It works from the perspective of the viewer. When a viewer opens YouTube Home or types in a search query, YouTube ranking works in two stages. The first one is candidate generation, and the second one is the actual ranking. But I'll leave that for this video right here, in which I talk about why keywords don't rank you. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.